Welcome to Bandung, the capital of West Java province in Indonesia and home to 2.5 million inhabitants. An innovative hub for creativity and entrepreneurship. There is a high potential for the development of creative industry in Bandung because of its location for the synergy and collaboration between universities, businesses, society, government, and media. The leading subsector of the creative industry in Bandung are various, from fashion, art and design, culinary, and tourism. It's definitely one of the vibrant creative cities in Indonesia that have many success stories for creative businesses. But today, with COVID-19 pandemic situation, we see the different face of Bandung. Empty tourism destination, silent street, with the creative society staying at home, the businesses are closed, where all the energy gone? Can they rebound and reshape their business strategy post-COVID-19? Join us today! Together, let's discover and reimagine the scene of Bandung Creative City. Starting from one of the pioneers in fashion business, Rumah Batik Komar. From 300 artisans in Bandung and Cirebon, become only 20 artisans. Less than 10 workers in a day. No visitors for batik educational workshop and customers. Many workers have to stay at home or isolate themselves due to COVID-19. A year survived in unexpected turbulence, a very challenging situation. What is Rumah Batik Komar and how they face the pandemic?
Could you please tell us about Batik Komar?
Batik Komar established in 1998 by Mr. Komaruddin Kudia and his wife, Mrs. Nuryanti Widya. So that's why this place called Rumah Batik Komar, because the owner's name is Komar.
Komar.
Well, in the beginning, Mr. Komar had only 3 workers, but now, at least before the pandemic, we had about 300 workers spread in Bandung and Cirebon. So besides selling the batik product, we also serve the batik education for those who want to learn about batik.
Okay, so pandemic is coming. Happened with Batik Komar?
We serve the artisan. We have a lot of artisans. So because the pandemic attacked all of us, so we have to shave it. For example, in a day we have 20 artisans, for example. So we have to shave it like, today we have only 10, and tomorrow we have only 10, something like that. But, and moreover, now Batik Komar more focused in online store. So we uploading products in e-commerce, something like that. And it works. The income, it's not like before pandemic, but it still works.
Do you have any kind of strategies facing the pandemic itself?
Facing the pandemic,
What do you think the innovative strategies that Batik Komar can do post COVID-19 to reset their business? From fashion, let's discover the tourism scene Kampung Adat Cirende. One of the only traditional village that still exists in Bandung area. Before the pandemic, they are always full of visitors almost every day. Several festivals conducted, and many visitors come to experience not only the traditional village, but also the unique traditional culinary from cassava, hike to the forest, and learn the history and culture directly from the local villagers. But today it is different. Tourism hit hard by the pandemic, as we have to stay at home. Social distance, all destinations must close during the lockdown restriction. How can they survive? Let's hear the story directly from the local villager.
Kenalin Kang ke teman-teman sekilas tentang Kampung Adat Cirende, boleh nggak Kang?
Boleh, boleh. Jadi Kampung Adat Cirende itu salah satu kampung yang berada di Kelurahan Leuwih Gajah, Kota Cimahi, yang masih mempertahankan nilai-nilai tradisi yang diwariskan oleh leluhur, terutama budaya makannya. Masyarakat adat Cirende adalah masyarakat adat yang tidak mengkonsumsi nasi beras seperti masyarakat pada umumnya, tapi memilih singkong sebagai makanan pokoknya.
Kang, ini yang menariknya lagi ya Kang ya, dari kampung adat jadi salah satunya juga terbuka juga buat wisata. Itu gimana sih Kang ceritanya?
Emang itu juga sama, tidak begitu gampang lah ketika kami yang muda-muda meminta restu atau izin kepada sesepuh bahwa kampungnya sering dikunjungi banyak orang, bagaimana kalau udah aja sebagai tempat wisata atau destinasi wisata. Kita bangun sebuah bisnis yang bisnis itu adalah bisnis sosial yang keuntungannya dibalikan lagi ke masyarakat. Ya barulah kita direstui untuk menjadi tempatnya dikunjungi banyak orang, tetapi harus ada nilai positif. Edukasi apa yang akan diberikan kepada pengunjungnya? Salah satunya pengenalan bahwa sumber pangan itu bukan hanya beras. Karena orang kita selalu belum ngomong belum makan ketika belum makan nasi beras. Meskipun makan bubur ataupun kupat tahu ya, ketika ditanya belum makan kalau belum ketemu nasi. Nah,
terus nih Kang ya, pandemi kan di mana-mana nih. Ini kerasanya buat kampung adat di sini kayak gimana Kang nih, Kang? Sebelum dan sesudahnya nih.
Kalau sebelum mungkin kami mulai mau menikmati dari kunjungan itu, ternyata ada hasil yang cukup lah buat kami, cukup untuk membangun, cukup untuk berkegiatan sosial di masyarakat, cukup untuk membangun ekonomi di masyarakat. Jadi masyarakat yang dulunya cuma bertani, mungkin mereka bisa berjualan dan sebagainya ketika kampung kami dikunjungi banyak orang. Ada hasil lah buat pribadi maupun buat komunitas. Ada hasil secara ekonomi. Tetapi setelah pandemi, memang kita mati. Tidak ada lagi kunjungan, apalagi paket yang kita jual kan target pasarnya anak-anak sekolah. Sekolahnya kan daring, tidak mungkin untuk dijual. Meskipun sekarang, kemarin di masa-masa PSBB, setelah dicabut oleh pemerintah, banyak orang yang datang ke sini setiap hari Minggu, yang bersepeda, yang berolahraga lah datang sini hanya untuk menikmati nasi goreng, menikmati banrek dan sebagainya. Setiap hari Minggu aja. Sekarang PPKM Jawa Bali ya kita tutup lagi.
Can you help Mr. Jajat and their community at Kampung Adat Cirende by giving them innovative action plan ideas to survive the pandemic and post COVID-19?